Hello and welcome back. In this video, I will help you buy the best MacBook for you based on your budget. Buying a MacBook might be intimidating. You have a ton of options to choose from, and after deciding on a model, you have tons of extra features that you can add on top of that, and in no time, you're well above your initial price target. Let's go to Apple's website and take a look. So let's say you want to buy the MacBook Air. Right off the bat, you have three options. The 13-inch with an M2 chip, the 13-inch with an M3 chip, and the 15-inch with an M3 chip. Let's say you'll go with the middle one, the 13-inch with an M3 chip. The base version comes with 8 gigs of RAM and 512 gigabytes of storage. But for an extra $200, you can double your RAM. And for an additional $200 on top of that, you can have the MacBook Air with 24 gigs of RAM. The same goes for upgrading the hard drive. If you want to double the storage, you have to pay an extra $200. And on top of that, if you pay $400 more, you can double that and you'll end up with a 2TB MacBook Air. But at this price point, you might be leaning into the MacBook Pro area. So why not start with the MacBook Pro from the beginning? So in order to help you, I've put together a list of 9 price categories, starting with the cheapest MacBook that you can buy and ending with the most expensive one. In between, we have 7 $500 range price brackets. But let's start from the beginning. The cheapest MacBook that you can buy right now, it's a 13-inch M2 MacBook Air with 8 gigs of RAM and 256 gigs of storage for $999. If you want the M3 version, you have to spend $100 more and you'll get the same laptop but with an M3 chip for $1099. Important note, all the MacBooks in this list have a 1TB hard drive. I reckon that anything below that, it's a bit too small for 2024. Let's continue with our second category, the $1,000 to $1,500 price bracket. In this range, you have two options, a 13-inch M2 or M3 MacBook Air, both with 8 gigs of RAM and 1TB hard drives. Going to our next category, the $1,500 to $2,000. This one is a bit more generous, with 8 MacBooks to choose from, 6 of which are MacBook Airs and 2 MacBook Pros. The cheapest in this category is a 13-inch M2 MacBook Air with 16GB of RAM, which costs $1,599. For $100 more, you have two options. At $1,699, you can either buy the 13-inch M3 MacBook Air or the 15-inch M3 MacBook Air. The downside of the 15-inch version is that it comes with only 8 gigs of RAM, while the 13-inch version comes with 16. So if screen real estate is what you're looking for and you don't mind having only 8 gigs of RAM, then you should go with the 15-inch MacBook Air. But otherwise, go with the 13-inch MacBook Air because it packs more RAM and you might need it at some point. And it's a bit more future-proof. Adding $100 more for $1,799, you have again two options. A 13-inch M2 MacBook Air or a 14-inch M3 MacBook Pro. The MacBook Air comes with 24 gigs of RAM, while the MacBook Pro with only 8. In this situation, it's a discussion about power versus memory. With the 13-inch MacBook Air, you have 24 gigs of RAM, quite a lot. But if you go with the MacBook Pro, you have an active cooling system and the possibility to have a bit more sustained workloads. Again, $100 on top of that, the price point of $1,899, at which we have again two candidates. This time it's MacBook Airs, the 15-inch M3 MacBook Air and the 13-inch M3 MacBook Air. Again, the difference is in the RAM. The 13-inch version comes with 24 gigs, while the 15-inch version with 16 gigs of RAM. The same discussion as previous, if you want more screen real estate, go with the 15-inch version, but if you want a bit more RAM and you want your laptop to be a bit more future-proof, then go with the 13-inch version. The last price point in this category, $1 below the 2000 mark, we have the 14-inch M3 MacBook Pro with 16 gigs of RAM. I would argue that this is a sweet spot, and in terms of buying a MacBook Pro version, this is a good starting point. Anything below 16 gigs of RAM will be a bottleneck for this computer, and you're better off buying a MacBook Air. Our next category, $2,000 to $2,500, brings us 4 choices. Going with the first one, at $2,099, you can buy the 15-inch M3 MacBook Pro with 24 gigs of RAM. For $100 more, at $2,199, you have two options again. This time we are talking about two 14-inch MacBook Pros, one coming with an M3 chip and one with an M3 Pro chip. The advantage of the M3 version is that it comes with 24 gigs of RAM, while the M3 Pro version comes with only 18. Again, it's a question about more memory versus more raw power. This time, I think I would actually go with the M3 Pro version, because 18 gigs of RAM is not that much below the 24 mark, and I think in most cases, it might be unnoticeable. If you have more than 18 gigs of RAM on your MacBook, I think you already know that and you know what you're gonna buy. At $2,399, we have the last MacBook in this category, a 14-inch M3 Pro MacBook Pro with 18 gigs of RAM. Compared to the previous one, this has the more powerful M3 Pro version, with 12 CPU cores and 18 GPU cores, compared with the previous one that had 11 CPU cores and only 14 GPU cores. So that's what you get for the $200 extra. Next one, $2,500 to $3,000. We have three MacBooks in this category, two 14-inch MacBook Pros and one 16-inch MacBook Pro. The first one at $2,599 is a 14-inch M3 Pro MacBook Pro with 36 gigs of RAM. For $100 more at $2,699, you'll get a 16-inch version MacBook Pro, but with only 8 gigs of RAM, but a slightly better CPU. The version that has 12 CPU cores and 18 GPU cores, compared to the 11 CPU cores and 14 GPU cores of the previous. $100 more on top of that at $2,799, you can buy the 14-inch MacBook Pro with an M3 Pro chip and 36 gigs of RAM. For our next category, $3,000 to $3,500, we have three MacBooks, two 16-inch MacBook Pro versions and one 14-inch MacBook Pro. So for $3,099, you can buy the 16-inch MacBook Pro with an M3 Pro chip and 36 gigs of RAM. This one packs the 12 CPU, 18 GPU core chip. Spending $100 more brings you to $3,199. At this price point, you can get the first M3 Max chip on a 14-inch MacBook Pro with 36 gigs of RAM. This M3 Max packs 30 GPU cores. The last one in this category is at $34.99, the same as above, but it's the 16-inch version, with an M3 Max chip and 36 gigs of RAM. Our next category, $3,500 to $4,000. At this price point, you'll have four options. By now, all of them have the M3 Max chip. So let's go with the first one. For $36.99, you can buy the 14-inch MacBook Pro with an M3 Max chip and 48 gigs of RAM. This M3 Max chip is the one that packs 16 CPU cores and 40 GPU cores. Spending $200 more, you'll get the same configuration but with 64 gigs of RAM. And now for $1 below $4,000, you have two options. The 14-inch MacBook Pro with an M3 Max and 48 gigs of RAM, or the 16-inch MacBook Pro with an M3 Max and 96 gigs of RAM. The later one has a slightly better CPU with 16 CPU cores and 40 GPU cores compared with the 14-inch version that only has 12 CPU cores and 30 GPU cores. I simply call the next category above $4,000, and we have three options. At $41.99, you can buy the 16-inch MacBook Pro with an M3 Max chip and 64 gigs of RAM. For just $100 more at $42.99, you can buy the same 16-inch MacBook Pro but with 96 gigs of RAM. The downside is that it has the slightly less powerful M3 Max chip with only 14 CPU cores and 30 GPU cores compared to the previous one that had the 16 CPU cores and 40 GPU cores. For $46.99, you can buy the 14-inch MacBook Pro, which has the best M3 Max chip and 128 gigs of RAM. This is the most expensive 14-inch MacBook Pro that you can buy with 1 TB hard drive. And for the last category, we just have the most expensive MacBook Pro that you can buy. For $49.99, you can buy the 16-inch MacBook Pro with the best M3 Max chip and 128 gigs of RAM. The only way to get above this price point is if you max out the storage. But that's available for every MacBook that we've gone through in this list, so I will not cover all the storage variations. That's been it. If you found this useful, please give a thumbs up and subscribe. See you soon, and don't forget, stay curious.